Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever the case may be. We are back and better than ever. I could not interrupt that great intro. Welcome to the Jungle Guns N' Roses. Today, we are still playing from the great CD Dave's Faves. This is one of his faves, produced by the great Darby Foster. And we are going to get straight to Arclink and Sector Area right now. We will come back, Axel. Yes, we will. All right. So, we know about all of these parts of a circle. Certainly, we know about the radius of a circle, the center of a circle. They don't have diameter, which goes all the way across through the center. A chord is any line segment whose endpoints are on the circle. So this is a chord, and actually the diameter is a chord. The radius is not, because it only has one point endpoint on the circle. A segment of a circle is like a partial area, as shown there, and a sector is like a piece of pizza there. And we're going to learn about area of sectors of circles. The arc is actually part of the circle. Now, it's very important. A circle is only the outer part. This outer ring is actually the circle. Inside is not the circle. It's inside of the circle, but it's not actually the circle. And we're going to be talking about arcs and their lengths. Segments of circles can be minor if they're less than half, and major if they're greater than half. A minor arc is less than half of the circle, and a major arc is greater than half of the circle. Arc length. So they actually, if you think about, if we were able to snip this off and straighten out measurement, it has a length. We refer to the arc length with the lowercase cursive letter L. The angle theta must be measured in radians, and we can use a ratio to obtain a formula. The arc length is going to be equal to theta divided by the circumference 2 pi. And then we set up a ratio, and we get the formula L equals theta r. L is the arc length. Theta is the angle used that cuts off that actual length, whose sides cut off that length. And r, of course, is the radius. Now, if you're just using theta, you got to be in radians, okay? In degrees, you got to put it over 360, and you have to do times the circumference. So it's always best to be in radians. And in fact, in our formula sheet, they only give us the formula in radians. So always work in radians. As far as the area of a sector, you can set up another proportion to get that, to get the formula here. I'll talk more about that in class. We solve the proportion and we get the formula area equals 1/2 theta r squared, and theta is in radians. Same dealio with degrees, but again, we want to stay in radians. All right, just a couple of examples. This is going to be short and short and sweet today. How's that? Is that better? I hope so. A sector has radius 12 centimeters and angle 3 radians. So I'm just going to draw it. You don't have to draw it. You can just crank it in the formula, but I like to draw just so we have a good understanding. So this looks to be about the center. It has a radius of 12 centimeters. Bam. So this is 12. A sector has radius 12 centimeters and angle 3 radians. So obviously a sector is part of the circle. 3 radians. So that would be, remember, a radian is the length of a radius pasted around the circle. So that would probably be, I don't know, maybe around here or so. Okay. So our angle is 3 radians right there. And this is a good example of why, where pi, you don't have to have the symbol pi to be in the measure of radians. Okay. So arc length, L equals theta r, nothing to it. So that's just going to be 3 times 12. So the arc length is equal to 36 centimeters, because the radius was given in centimeters. So the area is equal to 1/2 theta r squared. So that's going to be 1/2 times 3. Oh, that works out nicely, doesn't it? Why did I put 3 down there? 1/2 times 3 times the radius 12 squared. So that's this area right here we were talking about. And the arc length, I should have said, is this length right here, is actually 36 centimeters, right? Okay, so this is going to be, let's see, 3/2 times 144. And that's going to be, what, 72? And 3 times 72, 210, 6, 216 square centimeters. Easy peasy. All right, last example. Example 6, find the area of a sector with radius 8.2 centimeters and arc length 13.3 centimeters. All right, so I won't sketch that. I'm just going to go straight to the formulas. Area is equal to 1/2 theta r squared. Okay, so that would be 1/2. We don't have theta. We do have r, but I need theta. But I am told the arc length, and I know that the arc length is equal to theta multiplied by the radius. It's the same radius, obviously, because it's within the same circle. I am told that the arc length is 13.3, is equal to theta. Oh, it's the same angle, sorry. I said it's the same radius, obviously, but we're looking for theta. Theta. Shoo! Times the radius, 8.2. So 13.3 over 8.2 is equal to theta. And this is in radians. So I can take 1/2 times 13.3 over 8.2 times the radius squared, which would be 8.2. squared, and if you think about it, it just turns the 8.2s are going to cancel here. We can crank that on our calculator, and we will get about, so I should say about 54.5 square centimeters, rounded to 3 significant figures. All right, that is it. Hope you enjoyed it. I know that I did. And with that, let's go out with a little bit more of Axel and Welcome to the Jungle. So with that, I will say that I am out.